Hello, I'm Miguel de Salas. I am curator of botany here at the Tasmania Museum and Art Gallery, but when I'm not wearing my plant hat, I like to go out west and do a bit of fosking and prospecting. And so this exhibition we've had going here for the summer has been one of my favorite ones for the last few years because you can actually see some of the things I go looking for. So we've got a case in here, which goes over some of the mineral discoveries on the West Coast during the later part of the 19th century and the early part of the 20th century. And some of what I go and look for are two metals that you can find on the West Coast, gold and osmiridium. And so in here we've got a small jar of osmiridium from the Hazelwood River, which is somewhere between Waratah and Corinna. And it's one of those areas which is both botanically and in terms of minerals, really, really interesting. It's got this weird geology. You can find a lot of plants growing in there that don't grow anywhere else in the state, but you can also find a lot of the creeks have small amounts of gold and osmiridium. There's a little jar of osmiridium in the Hazelwood River. The history of osmiridium is absolutely fascinating in Tasmania because it's a metal that nowadays almost no one has ever heard of. But back in the 1910s, 1920s, and 1930s, osmiridium reached a price more than 10 times that of gold, and it had a really, really specific use. Osmiridium is one of the hardest metals known. It's a natural alloy of osmium and iridium, and it was used because it was used for making fountain pens. Now, most of the tips of fountain pens were made of gold, but gold, as you know, it scratches really easily. It's a very soft metal. So they found that by soldering a tiny little grain, like how they occur naturally in the river, they just took the little grains out of the river and you could solder one of these tiny little grains of osmiridium to the tip of your fountain pen nib and it wouldn't wear. And you could write with that fountain pen for years rather than having to replace the tip constantly. And for that use, miners, prospectors spread out all through the creeks on the west coast looking for this metal. Between about 1915 and about 1930. The industry died in about 1939 when a lot of people went off to war, and by the time they came back, the biro or normal sort of writing pen that we use today had been invented, the ballpoint pen, and there was no more need for osmiridium. Nowadays, iridium is used a little bit in the space industry and osmium has some medical applications, but there's very little demand for it compared to what there used to be. And the other one is gold, and we can see in here, these are plaster casts, replicas of the two largest gold nuggets ever discovered in Tasmania, which were found in 1883. The largest one was found by a prospector named James McGinty in the Rocky River near Corinna in 1883. Now, James McGinty is a guy who has a fascinating story, and I wish I had more time to tell you about it, but I don't. He was a gold prospector in the 1880s, working in the Corinna area. Then he went off to work in the Victorian goldfields for 20 years. And while he was there, he kept hearing that this metal osmiridium was increasing in price. Now, he knew what osmiridium was. He was a pretty cluey guy. Back in the 1880s, when all the miners were looking for gold, these are the metal that kept coming into their pans with their gold, and they were really upset about it because it weighed the same as gold. You couldn't separate it in the pan using gravity, and the mint would penalize them enormously for having this other metal contaminating their gold. Because he knew what it was, by about 1808, 1809, he thought, oh, well, it's worth enough. I know where there's enough of this stuff that I can go back to Tasmania and actually make a living out of mining it because we left a lot behind. So he came back and he pretty much single-handedly started the osmiridium industry in Tasmania as well. The area where these nuggets were found is pretty remote these days. Of course, there's no road access or anything like that. It's a tributary. The Rocky River is a tributary of the White River, which comes into the Pyman River, somewhere between Savage River and Corinna. But hardy prospectors even today go out there, hitch over their metal detectors and so on the hope of finding another big one. So far as I know, though, it's been no luck.